once drove his car in Nantucket. But that's another story.
We're on the road again, coming to you from Fort Myers in Sanibel Island, Florida. Dirty Water TV is next. Dirty Water TV, Dirty Water TV, Dirty Water TV, all over Boston you'll see. Dirty Water TV, wherever you want to be. Dirty Water, Boston, you're my seat.
It's going worldwide. Dirty Water.
And I love that Dirty Water TV.
Love that Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water TV.
I love that Dirty Water TV. I really do.
The best.
Ow! Welcome to Dirty Water TV. I'm Amanda Soucy.
And I'm Caroline Lenny, and we are coming to you from the beautiful Fort Myers, Florida, here at JetBlue Park.
Red Sox Nation is about to take over, as they do every year, when spring training begins here at JetBlue Park at Fenway South.
It's so gorgeous here. The sun is hot. You know, we have Shipyard Brewing to quench our thirst and keep you guys refreshed while you are touring all of the beautiful restaurants and eateries and here for all the baseball.
Yeah, Shipyard Brewing will make you feel right at home, a New England favorite. And we're also going to help you get right at home here in Fort Myers by showing you some of the best local eateries, some of our favorite spots.
So many wonderful hot spots. You guys have to come check it out. Let's go take a look.
Here's what's on tap. We'll introduce you to the Gulf Coast seafood aficionado, the one and only fishmonger, Matt Azen.
We'll go in style throughout Fort Myers and Sanibel Island, introducing you to Timbers Restaurant and Sanibel Grill, Mazzaluna Italian Eatery, The Prawn Broker, and University Grill.
And we'll sample the refreshing all-world taste of Shipyard beer.
So as you guys can see, we have a spectacular show set up for you here tonight with even a more spectacular view here behind us.
Our vacation here in Sanibel has been pretty easy on us, and we're about to make planning your vacation easier on you. We're going to tell you all the local spots to come visit while you're down here in Fort Myers and Sanibel Island for Red Sox spring training.
And when the sun sets, we're going to head on over to Sanibel Grill and Timbers to show you guys what that's all about.
But in the meantime, we're going to show you some of the beautiful views of Fort Myers and Sanibel, let you know what makes this island so beautiful, and why you need to come down and visit.
How amazing are all of those places?
Beautiful. This is an incredible island. A must-see. You know what else is a must-see? Where we are right now, here at the Sanibel Grill in Timbers Restaurant.
I'm starving. Let's go check it out.
Let's hit up the sushi bar. Timbers Restaurant and Fish Market, along with Sanibel's only true sports bar, the Sanibel Grill, have been serving locals and New Englanders for almost four decades. Timbers Restaurant has established itself as one of the island's busiest and best restaurants, serving only the best seafood, from red snapper to its legendary crunchy grouper, steamed clams, delectable sushi, and a 600 oyster bar.
The fish is really fresh, which is good, because everybody down here is like a fish expert.
If you're looking for casual fare, look no further than the Sanibel Grill. With ice-cold Shipyard brew available, the Sanibel Grill will make New Englanders feel right at home.
I'm drinking the Florida brewed Shipyard Blood Orange. It's awesome.
And I'm having a wonderful Shipyard IPA Monkey Fist.
See, the blood.
And make sure to take in the remarkable memorabilia collection, including many authentic Red Sox historical pieces.
And I got this Cuban cigar box signed by Luis Tejans. It's Yaz, and he signed that one. Of course, I was playing in the Yankees Legends game, and he was nice enough to even sign it for me, the Yankee thing.
We're here sitting down at Sanibel Grill with the fishmonger himself, Matt Azen. Matt.
The one and only.
The one and Azen. Yeah. The one and Azen.
I like that. That's good. That's really good.
So I did a little bit of due diligence on you. I hear that your grandfather was a dentist.
Correct.
Your father was a dentist.
Correct.
So how'd you get involved in the restaurant business?
Well, I didn't want to pull teeth. I figured it'd be easier to fillet a fish. They don't complain. You can't really hurt them. And then you can sell the parts for money. And I had enough dentists in my family. My cousins were dentists, so
You didn't need any more dentists. Right. You were like, I've got this.
And I just got addicted to the food business and the people business, and I don't want to look in people's mouths. I wanted to hear from their mouths instead.
So you have 5 wildly successful restaurants. What do you think it is about your locations that keeps people coming back for more?
Well, here on Sanibel, we're on Sanibel. So there's only a limited number of restaurants, and we've been consistent, been trying hard. We just want to make the people happy. I say treat them like my mother's coming in here, make sure everything is right, and be fair and consistent, and we've been doing that for 38 years.
From what I understand, you not only run this place, but you pick up the fish as well. Everything has to be completely fresh. Let's go check out Joe and Matt earlier at the docks today.
How's it all? We got lots of fish.
You know what they say, I know jack about fish. The Cadillac of groupers. Wow. Is that pretty? He's got one of those sad faces. Oh, I guess I'd be sad too if I was gonna be getting cut up for dinner. This is pompano. It's very small and very delicious. Buttery texture. And here's Andres is filleting the pompano. This is how we get our fish. 200 pounds of golden tile fish, 200 pounds of red snapper, some grouper, beautiful fish. And it's right off the boat. And we bring it in here and Tay fillets it. And it doesn't get any fresh in it. And that's what has really made our business. I still enjoy going down there and seeing this stuff right off the boat. It's like a new experience all the time. It's so wonderful to see real, fresh, you know, instead of farm to table, this is Gulf to table by way of my truck, yeah.
So rumor on the street is you have a nickname for your oyster, for being something like the Oyster King. What do we call you?
Well, I'm an oysterfarian. I'm a master mermelier. And I'm in the oyster hood.
Look at this.
And this is a silver Kushi oyster from the West Coast. But over the last 6 years, I've started collecting the oysters that I've eaten and the shells. And I just hit the 700 different oyster count. And I said, if I ever hit 400, I'll quit. And then if I ever hit 500, I'll quit. Well, now I'm at 700, and I'm not quitting because there's more of them, and I still love eating them. And I meet people. If I'm in an oyster bar in New York or in London or in anywhere I go in Washington, and people say, why is he saving the shells? Oh, he collects oysters. Why do you collect oysters? I'm in the business. Here's my card. Let's talk oysters. And we make new friends. And we share the oyster experience with people. And it's good for my business, and it's good for the world.
Shipyard has been coming to all of your restaurants this week. How has it been? Give everyone a little taste of the deliciousness.
Well, it's great. We're trying to feature a lot of local beers. And now Shipyard, which is originally from Portland, Maine, where I summer, and I've drank it up there, has a brewery in Clearwater, so now they're brewing beer here and distributing it here so I can get it easily, and it's a great product, and the people are really taking off with it.
Kind of like, you know, the beer of your soul, I think.
Well, it can be the new beer of my soul. It's my new favorite beer, and that's all that matters.
Well, thank you so much for everything, Alchemy, every day.
Come on down to Florida if the snow's getting to you. We look forward to seeing you here.
Joining us now is Dan Bulldog, the district manager for Shipyard down here in Florida. Dan, I hear you're a New England native?
Yeah, I'm from Maine.
So how does Shipyard, the New England vibe, fit down here in Florida?
Well, actually, in a number of ways. Our name is very nautical. Our branding is very nautical. A lot of water down here in Florida. So it translates actually very well for us.
A lot of water. We're all tied together by the ocean, right?
Exactly. Dirty water and Shipyard. Just here tonight alone, we met many people from Maine. They know the brand. They know the beer already, and it fits well with down here. Tonight we actually have our Monkey Fist IPA, which is our a little bit more alcohol to it for an IPA, 6.9. And then we have our Florida Blood Orange. The Florida Blood Orange is actually a new product for Shipyard this year. This particular beer is brewed year-round in Florida, but the rest of the country, including Maine, is a seasonal beer.
Yeah.
So this is a big hitter for us. So the Blood Orange is actually, it's considered a Belgian wit beer. This year has a little bit higher alcohol. It's a 5.1%. So
maybe people, that's why everybody likes it so much.
Yeah, you don't really taste the alcohol. That's the dangerous part. But if you were going to compare it to some of the mainstream beers, very similar. However, those beers are unfiltered, so they're very cloudy, almost a pulp look to it. This here is a filtered beer, so it's got a really nice, clean, crisp taste as well as look to it. Really easy to drink, especially down here in the hot sun. So this is a great beer on draft or in bottle.
I heard some great news.
Yeah. Yeah.
What are they going to be serving at JetBlue Park?
So this year, actually, we're going to be serving Shipyard and or a Sea Dog product at JetBlue Park.
So it's like the perfect accompaniment to a Red Sox game.
Definitely. You can have a great Shipyard or Sea Dog beer at one of these great restaurants or at JetBlue Park.
Up next, we'll go Italian at Mazzaluna and sample a true family-style dining experience.
And later, it's off to Fort Myers and the University Grill. That's when Dirty Water TV, presented by Shipyard Brewing, returns.
One of the newest photos last week, and one of my favorite photos, is when I met Billy Crystal here in Fort Myers. And of course, I brought in a salmon, and the punchline, when Harry met salmon. Billy thought that was a riot. And some other pictures, which have been here for a while, now take new meaning. We have Donald Trump, who at the time was just a New York realtor. And I said, no, Donald, I'll be president and you can be vice president. But he didn't go for that.
Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Caroline.
And I'm Amanda.
And here we are at the beautiful Mazzaluna restaurant.
Say it with a little Italian flair there, Caroline.
Mazzaluna, here in Sanibel Island in Florida.
We're warming up for spring training. While you guys are freezing up north, we're checking out some of the hottest
spots.
Don't
worry, guys. We've got you covered. We're checking out all the hottest spots. So when you come down here for spring training, you know exactly where to go. Don't worry, we've got you covered.
We're going to teach you how to pour a perfect pour of Shipyard beer. And Caroline's going to head into the kitchen and teach you how to make the perfect pizza.
I got to check something off my bucket list tonight and make a pizza. I was throwing it up in the air. This Irish girl went full-blown Italian. So come on with us and check out this beautiful spot. Mazzaluna opened in 1994 and has become known as Sanibel's Italian Kitchen.
In honor of the Tom Brady and the New England Patriots, we have the Patriots Pizza. It's New England clam chowder on top of a pizza with bacon and scallions.
Oh, yeah.
And if you're not sure how great it is, the second half is much better than the first half. And of course, you gotta wash it down with some Shipyard beer.
There we go.
Wonderful.
In addition to Sanibel's only wood-fired pizza oven, Iron Chef Award winner Sal Velez offering a changing weekly specials featuring local seafood. Mazzaluna's legendary calamari is succulent and crispy, while their sauces are rich and flavorful.
Now that's a spicy meatball.
Mazzaluna is conveniently located on Periwinkle Way, just a half a mile from the Fort Myers Causeway. Stop in before or after a Red Sox spring game and enjoy a truly authentic Italian meal. And pair that with a New England tradition, Shipyard beer. Hey guys, I'm here with the GM here, Michael Murphy. What's going on? There's a lot of Boston roots here in this restaurant. So tell me a little bit about that.
Well, the Boston roots in the restaurant, one of our waitresses, Maureen, grew up in the Boston area. She actually works at Fenway Park in the fall, and she works spring training for the Boston Red Sox for 25 years.
It's like Fenway South, and everybody's happy. It's the beginning of baseball season, so it's a great time of year.
It's a lot of fun to work here. It's a lot of fun to be here. The guests have a great time here. Been here 22 years. They're doing a lot of things right here.
As the GM, do you have hiring abilities?
I do have hiring abilities.
So after, you know, my skills that I've showcased this evening, do I have a good shot?
Pretty good shot. The only thing we need to see you do is toss the pizza up in the air.
I got that. Let's do this. We've got the Shipyard Blood Orange here, and then we have the Shipyard Monkey Fist. That's a big hit here tonight. So which one is your favorite, the Blood Orange or the Monkey Fist?
Monkey Fist IPA, no doubt.
That there's only one thing left for me to do, and I think it's we gotta hit the tap.
We gotta see this, if you can pour a beer or not.
Wow, that's a big head.
Yeah.
Up next, we're off to Fort Myers and the Prawn Broker Fish Market and Restaurant.
And we'll take you to the classic American eatery, the University Grill. That's when Dirty Water TV, presented by Shipyard Brewing, returns.
Hey, what's up, Boston? Welcome back to Dirty Water Does Florida. I'm Caroline Lunny.
And I'm Amanda Susi. And tonight, we are coming to you from Prawn Brokers, located in Fort Myers. It is the perfect post-spring training place to go if you need to cool down with a Shipyard beer.
I can't get enough of this monkey fist. Like, this is just... I'll be back.
And tonight we have a lot of the promo girls here. We're Shipyard passing around some samples, letting people know about this great flavor. Let's go see what Prawn Brokers is all about.
Located in Fort Myers, the Prawn Broker Restaurant and Seafood Market is where you'll find all your favorite local seafood, steaks, and more. The Prawn Broker is committed to buying local and giving you the freshest seafood Fort Myers has to offer. You guys are having some Shipyard. What did you guys order for dinner?
Yellowtail snapper.
Yellowtail snapper. You ordered something in Boston. The Boston haddock.
I got the New England clam chowder.
All right, so I'm here with Sabrina. She's one of the great waitresses here at Prawn Brokers here in Fort Myers. Can you tell me, as a first timer, I've never been here before, what should I order off the menu?
All right, so our black and white sesame tuna, super fresh and delicious, pan-seared with a teriyaki glaze. Scampi pasta with golf-sized shrimp on top, and our crunchy grouper, which is known and famous here in local Fort Myers for over 30 years, and it's tossed in cornflakes, so that's what makes it super special.
What should I wash it down with?
Shipyard beer. It's one of our top sellers right now. Super fresh, crisp, and delicious.
Okay, Amanda, as much as I hate to leave this place, we've got to go and check out all the other places so the people back home know where to go when they're down here for spring training.
I'm pretty excited about our next stop. We're going to head over to University Grill.
Come on with us. Let's go.
Hey, guys. I'm Paige here in beautiful Fort Myers, Florida. We're at University Grill, and thanks to Shipyard, we're checking out some cool spots in the area. Let's go.
So, Caroline, have made our way over from Prawn Brokers to University Grill.
And I am starving, okay? The food here looks absolutely amazing. Fish here looks so fresh, and I just, like, wanted to try a bite of everybody's on the way over.
You know what? I heard that the chef is actually from New England. So we have a little bit of a New England flair to the cooking that we have here. And what else do we have?
Shipyard.
The best way to wash down a nice New England meal with a New England beer. University Grill, known for seafood, steaks, and martinis, has been serving Floridians for almost two decades. This legendary American eatery is an upscale bar and grill. They offer high-choice aged meats and fresh seafood paired with ice-cold Shipyard beer. Chef Ed Vizella, a Massachusetts native, is the master of slow-roasted prime rib, and his ingenuity with haddock dishes continue to amaze all.
Get a little homey thing going on for you here. Chowder, lobsters, clams, haddock. It was none of that stuff when I came here, so I had to make my own.
Stop by before or after Red Sox games. And don't forget, University Grill now offers the New England tradition, Shipyard beer. Serve ice cold, of course.
When the Red Sox moved down here in 1993, we started slowly but surely getting a lot of New England, Northeast type people. 8 years ago, I couldn't give away any of this stuff. Now I probably sell, more haddock than anybody in the state. I have a hard time getting it. We sell so much of it, and it's probably 20% of our sales. Same thing with fried clams. Tonight, I mean, they won't even be on the menu. I'll tell the bar, I'll tell a couple of servers, and they'll be gone that fast.
Yeah, I'm noticing a lot of New England influence on all of this, from the fluffinutter, that's on your menu?
Yeah, well, for the kids' menu.
Because
we have to teach them right. The chowder, as a company, with all the stores that we have, all of them pretty much have chowder with cream, milk, or whatever. Here, we do a little bit more of a Rhode Island. It's a clear broth, it's healthier. The fish cakes are a staple. The lobster tails sell, a lot. This is just a neighborhood bar and grill. The food, emphasis is on food.
And this is it, the New England Fair.
The perfect way
to wash down haddock, baked beans, clam chowder.
Yeah, and that's actually a Boston cream pie. They're individuals.
All the details. It's time for us to eat.
All right. Yeah. Yeah.
Cheers, guys. Thank you.
All right. Enjoy. Salute.
Thanks, Ed. It's been a pleasure talking to you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you much.
Cheers, baby. Up next, we'll wrap things up from the Fort Myers, Sanibel Island. That's when Dirty Water TV, presented by Shipyard Brewing, returns.
This one got me thrown out of Fenway Park. Ninth inning, Red Sox-Yankee game, held it up. Jorge Posada came out, saw it, pointed it out to A-Rod. They came out of the dugout, cracking up. They saw the picture, they saw the sign. Security grabbed me by the collar, said, "Okay, you're out of here." And I walked out, holding the sign up. I said, hey, it's Fenway, isn't it? They go, doesn't matter. You're out of here. This was my first NBA basketball sign when I was a Knicks fan. It was Mother's Day. It was over 30 years ago because my mother was alive. And I went to Chicago to see the Knicks play the Bulls, Michael Jordan. My mother said, why don't you come to New York and visit me on Mother's Day? I said, well, I got to be in Chicago for this big game. So I made that sign, and it was on TV, and my mother was watching it because I told her to watch the game, and I said, I love you, Mom, but oh, that Michael Jordan. And from there on, it's history.
Welcome back to Dirty Water TV. Unfortunately, the time has come we got to call this little June vacation, call it to an end. I don't want to go. They don't want us to go.
It doesn't stop here. You know, we've had the best time, and we just want to say thank you so much to everybody over at Shipyard.
And of course, Matt Azen, the owner of all the great restaurants we had the chance of visiting, from Prom Brokers to Matalunas to Sanibel Grill and Timbers.
We've had the best time.
Come on down. Join me in a Shipyard here in sunny Florida. Florida's favorite new beer.
Yeah. All right, for humans and dogs alike.
The weekend may be over.
But the party never ends on Dirty Water TV.
I once drove this car in Nantucket, but that's another story.
Welcome back to Dirty Water TV.
All right, I am rolling.
Welcome back to Dirty Water TV. From Matsaluna to
Prom Broker,
Sanibel Grill, oh, and Shipyard and Dog, of course.
American Red Snapper. Uh-oh, don't get away. Down here we got some beautiful grouper, black grouper. Look at the eye on that thing. It's black as night. That's how you tell. You look at the eye, you look at the gills. Oh, baby. Good luck to kiss a fish.